Hi, hey, I'm Rick Taylor. I'm Senior Technical Architect with Proficient, and I'm here with Rackspace hosting here at TechEd in Atlanta, Georgia, and having a good time. Just got done with my session on SharePoint security.
Mr. Rick Taylor of
Proficient.
Yeah. So we're here at TechEd, and Rick, you just finished delivering your session here. Are you doing one or two?
I did one.
Doing one.
Yep, and now I'm just the booth.
And what was it about?
It was about SharePoint security using the OSI model as a guide. So I had a real sexy title.
Yeah.
The 10 Immutable Laws of SharePoint Security. So, you know, they really thought that was really cool. So I wanted to talk about, you know, where security lies in the OSI model,
right,
what the attack surfaces were, and how to take care of that. As SharePoint administrators, we typically think of permissions, we think of authorization and authentication, but we don't really think about where we're vulnerable outside of SharePoint.
For instance,
if I were to just take your server, what good does SharePoint do you?
Doesn't matter how tight your SharePoint security is if you don't have the server.
Right, if I am the only farm admin and there's nobody else, if someone takes my server, it doesn't matter. And it also proves that not only is it all about SharePoint, it's a holistic kind of a view. And so I move up the OSI model, so we know that there's seven layers, and at the bottom is the physical layer.
Yeah.
And a lot of people take that for granted, but I mean, think about it. If your neighbor stole your cable, right, cut it, split it, now they get free cable.
Right.
Okay, you can kind of do the same sort of a thing in a network. So the SharePoint admins need to work with their Active Directory or network admins to make sure that all their security is really tight.
So it's not necessarily just about, you know, who has rights to something in SharePoint. It's a
Correct.
Holistic security policy as it relates to the application of SharePoint.
Absolutely. I mean, think about DNS, for example. Without DNS, you can't get to any of the sites. So if I poison your DNS cache and not maliciously, but even on accident, let's say that the network security guys were not diligent in putting the IP addresses of the authoritative DNS servers in their console, and they just said, you know what, any DNS server is going to be good. Well, you know what, if one DNS server happens to point to the wrong address, then nobody can get to their site. And so, you know, that's one of the things that people take for granted, you know.
Okay.
Hey, those are really important things that have to do with security, not necessarily SharePoint.
It's a good point about security. A lot of times people will ask me questions about managing documents, and they want to know how SharePoint manages documents. And so my answer back to them is, well, what is your records retention policy? Which is a document that has nothing to do with SharePoint. It
Correct.
Has everything to do with how do I manage the business record of the things that I make my decisions on inside of my business as they're stored in SharePoint, as a ancillary detail.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, a lot of people think of SharePoint as a one-off kind of a thing. You
it's
know, SharePoint
special
is
and different.
Exactly.
No,
it's
just
like
another,
you know,
enterprise app.
You've got Exchange, you've got SQL, you've got SharePoint, you've got all kinds of other applications and servers in your whole enterprise.
Yes.
And they should be treated as a living soul. They're all appendages of your enterprise.
That's right. And so, as it relates to security, then it's what is your security policy for your internal, and in some cases, external systems?
Yep.
And how does SharePoint fit into that policy? First, it'd always be, how does it fit into what exists? And then the next question is, are there aspects of what SharePoint is doing that don't apply or don't fit, or there isn't a subsection 5X3, subsection 3?
Yep.
And then at that point, you then modify for it.
That's right, and you have to be flexible. It's just like any other policy that needs to be reviewed, audited, and updated.
Right.
And we also talk about in my session about network access policies, you know, anybody just coming into the network. You know, there's a lot of enterprises that have contractors and temporary employees, and they weren't issued a laptop by the company.
Right.
And so they just come in and they jack into the network and they get access. Well, you know, what are they bringing into your network?
What are they bringing in and what are they taking out?
Exactly. If you're not inspecting the wire, then they may be bringing something that you don't want or taking things that you don't want.
That's right.
And so what the network access policy does is it says, oh, I'm going to put you in timeout until I can validate that you're clean.
Right.
So that's one of the things that we talk about. That's all part of your security, because you don't want someone, you know, that may download a document and then upload it. You know, okay, well, I've got Forefront on my, so okay, well, that's good. That's
right.
One layer.
Right.
But you got to think of security as layers.
So consider the seven layers of the OSI model.
Correct.
And what impact does that have on bringing the application of SharePoint into your organization?
Yeah,
so let's think about maybe we should write a series on the five documents that don't need updated for SharePoint.
Yeah.
They just need SharePoint needs to be applied to them.
That's right. That's exactly right. So, you know, even you know, a lot of people talk about SharePoint Designer and how evil it is, right? Well, you know, how do I block people from using it? Well, group policy. Right? I don't want you installing SharePoint Designer on your machine.
Wait, where do I find group policy in SharePoint?
Exactly.
I don't.
Exactly.
It's not SharePoint.
It's not SharePoint.
But
it's part
of
your network.
It.
Yeah, absolutely. So, and someone, your contractor, may have SharePoint Designer. They come into your network. Hey, now with group policy, you know, if I see it, I remove it.
Right.
And that has nothing to do with SharePoint. It has to do with your network and Active Directory security.
Yeah, so you know, people often say, when they come to us and they want at Rackspace, and they'll say, I want some SharePoint. And what version do I need? Well, I'll ask them, you need the one I want to sell you, because I want to, you know, we're in the business to make money. But that's not what we say. What we say is, what are your business requirements? I don't know, but I've read it, Ken. No, stop. I'm going to put you in contact. I'll sell you servers all day long, but I'm going to put you in contact with a consulting company who can listen to your business needs and then apply those needs to the aspects of SharePoint that apply. And then of those aspects of SharePoint that apply, let's talk to the rest of the teams inside of your organization. Let's talk to security. Let's talk to legal. Let's talk to business records and make sure that those specific pieces don't have an impact.
Absolutely. It's all a enterprise business type of decision. It can't be made by one specific group. Or, you know, I mean, what's the goal? The goal is everybody holding hands singing Kumbaya at the end.
Right,
and
collaborating together.
You can't do that if it's a, you know, one person is making, you know, a unilateral decision, or one group.
Yeah, and I've seen a lot of that from an issue perspective that, you know, you're gonna be the SharePoint guy. They've named you the SharePoint guy. So everybody comes to you to ask, well, how are we gonna implement records? Or how am I gonna implement security? You tell me how we're going to implement security. This is your business. This is your infrastructure. When you brought email in, what did you do? When you brought in contract processing, what did you do? When you brought in XYZ, what did you do? This is just another thing.
Yep.
Granted, it does all everything better, and it's the shiny bell right now.
That's
Everybody
right.
likes it.
That's right.
But have a governance plan and make that governance plan fit into your existing
Absolutely.
Enterprise.
And you know that the SharePoint's a great place to put your governance plan. You know, integrated into your sites. And so now people can actually go to a site and say, you know, how do I do this? You know, I've got a special control on there. It will take me to maybe a CBT that I put on my site, or my training site, and now, you know, I've got it. Well, what's the, you know, the policy for this? It takes me to the policy site. You know, there's all kinds of things you can do with SharePoint, but you have to think of it as a whole business type of a thing. It's all one thing.
Yeah, we're running a little long, but the one other thing on that is oftentimes when I see SharePoint come in, HR gets involved and they want to draft all these new policies around what you are and are not allowed to do inside of SharePoint. You know, the blogs, the wikis, it really still freaks a lot of people out. But at the end of the day, it really is just turn it back around. What is your electronic asset policy at your company? Just apply that to SharePoint,
sure.
And it's all the same. It makes sense to remind people what they've agreed to when they got their computers or their laptops or their cell phones, but it's all just the same.
It is. It really is.
Awesome. All right. Rick Taylor. He knows
right.
a lot.
Thank you so much for your time.
How can people find you?
Oh, they can find me either at my blog. Oh, gee. Which one? blogs.technet.com/ritaylor, or you can go to blogs.proficient.com, or you can go to slickrickisthemann.wordpress.com.
Awesome. Thanks.